Okay, the unit itself holds 1,700 millilitres of water. It weighs in at 3.25 kilograms, and its height overall . Okay, this is the unit with the measure in it now. We're producing out of the same unit here, and you can see that each segment is 250 millilitres. There's four of them. This is my fill line for my water level when I'm using the measuring section, and this is my fill line here for when I'm using the spark arrestor. Now, once I've measured what I want to produce up onto this top lip, I simply open the valve, down it goes, shut the valve, and I start to measure again. And you'll see that each segment, once it comes up to the top lip, that should produce 250 millilitres. You don't need three sets of hands for one thing. You can be doing stuff over here and keep an eye on it. It's dead easy to operate, and it's easy viewed, and you know, it's just dead simple. So I mean, they're a very handy thing to either build for yourself or, you know, have one built for you. You've got two British Gas ball valves. It'll handle 25 litres a minute, although I don't think most years are going to produce that kind of. See, that's my up to my mark, so I'll set my timer and continue. But it gives you the consistency that you want if you're testing on a bench, because these are bench test units. Obviously, it's not a unit you'd carry about in the car, although it's handy if you want to take it out to the car. And when we've done, down she goes. Let me just pull the measure out. And you can see where the water level is. And if I was going to use it as a spark arrestor, I would bring the water level probably up right close to there. And again, it depends on how much you're producing, because you don't want bubbling going back down the pipe. So again, that's a pretty much feel for yourself where you want it to be. But when it's a spark arrestor, you've got that bubbly cling film. So you've basically got maybe 150 millilitres of gas in here, which is a fairly small amount, but it's a loud enough amount if your ears will be ringing if it goes off. But again, it will not affect your equipment. It will not travel through the heady water, as I'll show you in a minute. But again, you just don't want to be exploding it in the house or stuff, because, well, you deafen yourself, to be honest. Or done it being there. But you don't want this much gas. You want a smaller amount. That's where you bring it up to the virtually the edge of the pipe. It's just a safety precaution, so. When you want to use your measure, you just pop it back in, and off you go with your measure again. Throw the switch, shut your valve, and that's you measuring again. Very handy unit to build yourself for. Acquire yourself if you're doing test bench stuff. I mean, I've sort of got a number of them lying about. To be honest, I find them very handy. And it's a 3-in-1, so it's just the one instrument to do the three things that you probably want to do, eh? It's a nice design. I wouldn't have changed the design, to be honest with you. I mean, you know, it took me a... Simple as it is, it took me a couple of months to actually come up with the design and a few sort of trial and error ones, so... But I wouldn't have changed the design now I have it. It's absolutely fit for purpose, very functional. So, okay, there you go, guys. Okay, I'll go on and show you the spark arrestor now. Of course, what I'm going to do is put the double wrapped elastic band, it's well stitched, and a double layer of cling film on it. Okay, I've connected my two connections up. I throw my switch. Start producing. Hear it coming down through up into the unit in a minute. There we go. Got gas. So this is where my gas is coming out of. If we have any kind of ignition source coming back in the unit, it's going to hit here first. So let's shut this and I'm going to show you what happens. This starts to fill up, so we've got an ignition source, but it's going to go bang. You get an instant stop with the gas coming out because of the shock wave comes down through the water. Can you see that? Boom. You see what I'm doing? So what you've got is an explosion happening here. The shockwave travels down through the water and basically plugs the pipe. As long as we turn the thing off. So your explosion will be coming in, up, a current up here. Like electricity or anything else, it's going to take its easiest road out through the cling film. Can you see? The heady water jams the pipe, stops the gas, so any explosion comes out this direction. It's a simple yet effective method of having a spark arrestor. And the rest of the time, you can have your pipe in acting as a bubbler. As soon as you shut your valve, explosion happening here is going to come out through the cling film. Any pressure is going to go down and block your pipe. Shut that, you'll see what I mean. Bang, see? Simple yet effective. Very, I mean, it's going to make a heck of a noise because when you blow these, you've got a bit of gas in there. You've probably got 150 millilitres of gas in there. And believe me, it's going to make one. Your ears are going to ring, but your machinery and your stuff's going to be safe. You shouldn't use the nature of the spark arrestor. I'll just show you that one more time. Can you see? It's like any kind of explosion or electrical force, it's going to take the easiest road out, which is, again, through the cling film. Okay. Simple enough.